said, God, what are you trying to say? He said, you'll never know what kind of foundation you have unless something comes against it. You'll never know that you're delivered from people until I stop having people pay attention to you. They stop being one of your people. See, our ladder leans up against many walls, but only God knows which one is the truth, true wall. And so I'm here to say, I know it's not making you feel too good, but you will be disappointed in people, in yourself, in life. Deal with it. Deal with it. But don't deal with it within yourself. Hash it out before God. So anger and bitterness don't take root. See, if you don't hash it out before God, anger and bitterness will take root. And then your life is spoiled, defiling everybody it comes in contact with. All because you were disappointed. God never said we wouldn't be disappointed. I said, God never said we wouldn't be disappointed. God never said we wouldn't have hurts. God never said we won't suffer great rejection. What kind of Bible y'all reading? I don't want it. You listening to me? He said, Jesus, can I quote him? I think he's alive. He said, they did it unto me. Yes. They'll do it unto you. But what's the good news? Say, give me some good news. And then I'm going to wrap this up with some good news. He said this. The torrent burst against that house. But it couldn't shake it. Because it was well built. I want you to know that no matter what you're going through, whether it's divorce, a loss of a loved one, a home, a possession, a business, God is building you to such a degree that no matter what you have or don't have, you won't be easily shaken by it. When you start letting life circumstances define you, you have lost your focus. I don't know why God don't want to give me this. I had this. Then can he do a new thing? Can he bring it back to you around a different kind of way? Now, that might not be the proper grammar, but I want to use it like that. Can he bring it to you in a different form, a different shape? Or are we so bent on him doing one thing one way? So in the process of life, the flood could not shake that person because he had been well built. And if you want to know who you like, look at how you are when life happens. I'm not talking about the moment that you got to get your footing, where you have to stabilize yourself. I'm not talking about that while you're trying to find your way. Who am I talking to? See, God give us a moment to get our footing because he knows that we're human. But once you have got your footing, then you stand. Having done everything that you can do, you just stand and let him take you through that process of your life. Not feeling like that thing had determined who you are or what you shall be, or telling you it cannot be again. The devil is a liar. And just because you struggled once, that don't mean you won't struggle again. That's right. But what the good news is that on the other side of that is information. Information that is valuable, that money cannot buy, that is, you know that no matter what you're facing, God will always be there with you. He will never, for him to say, I'll never leave you or forsake you, saints, mean that you have to experience some things that you think will cause you to forsake him. That went over your head. I said that just went over all of y'all head. Just because you would forsake somebody in the midst of certain circumstances doesn't mean he would. And he has to prove it to you. So that you become bedrock in your faith. And you're solidified in your faith. Knowing this, no matter what, there's so much fear out here, so much fear of losing this and losing that. And God is saying, all of that's going to continue until you know that even with or without that, I am still right here. I'd rather have that than have money. I'd rather to know that God will be with me and make a way out of no way than for me to search after something that is not lasting. Give him a chance to do something new. Give him a chance to do something fresh. Why don't you? Why don't you be the first to say yes to the Lord? Yes to your will. Yes to your way. We don't like it, but he didn't make a mistake. If you lost somebody and you still living, he didn't make a mistake. It's all a part of his process of bringing you to where you are. And let me tell you that failure, I wrote this down, I gotta read this to you. Everyone fails in life. Everyone. But failure can be a gift if you don't give up.